Today, I'm going to answer an extremely common question and address some common misconceptions about Rebase. You're also going to want to stick around because I'm going to talk about a must-know use case for Rebase that you can apply right now. Let's start with a basic Git repository with a single feature branch. Now, this feature is done, and we're going to have to merge those changes back onto mainline. Now, what we're looking at here is my local repository, but if we take a peek at the remote counterpart of this repository, you can see that there's been a commit pushed to mainline by another contributor after we split off to work on our feature branch. Now, naturally, before we do anything, we want to grab that change, so I'll run git pull. But now that I've got that latest commit back on my local mainline, the situation becomes a little bit more complex. How do we get our feature branch changes back onto mainline while accounting for this other commit? Well, what about Rebase? Yes, Rebase is a good choice here, but maybe not in the way that you are originally expecting. We can first use Rebase to re-anchor the feature branch off of the most recent commit we just pulled from remote. To do this, all we need to do is check out our feature branch using git checkout feature branch, and then we run git rebase mainline. Now, the result will be this, but let's slow it down so we can take a look at what's actually happening under the hood, because therein lies a common misconception. When I run git rebase mainline, Git starts by setting aside these commits into a temporary holding area. It then reapplies them one by one on top of the latest mainline commit. Since Git commits are immutable, in other words, they cannot be changed, the commits you now see on your feature branch are technically duplicates of the originals. Now, for many intents and purposes, this distinction is not very important. However, you need to be aware of this if the branch you're rebasing on is shared by other contributors. As a rule of thumb, if your feature branch is local only, rebase is pretty safe. If not, avoid rebase because that operation technically erases and then rewrites history, which can cause issues for your other contributors if they've already pulled down the original commits. Here comes the pro workflow tip. Periodically running this rebase operation to re-anchor your feature branches allows you to iteratively keep up to date with remote changes. The key part of this is that you're spreading out the work of keeping your feature branch up to date, so you don't have to do it all at once at the end. All right, so we've re-anchored. Now what? Well, first, I hate it when creators ask for subscriptions before they've had a chance to earn it. These animations take a really long time to produce, and I think they're the best way to understand tricky Git topics, but sending a subscription my way would be very much appreciated if you have a quick second. And you can also follow along with my learngit.io project where I'm building a high quality collection of Git learning resources, including more videos and interactive tools, things like that. That's gonna be released later this year, but you can sign up for the waitlist at the link in the description or on your screen. All right, back to the video. With our feature branch up to date with our remote head commit, we have some easier merging options ahead of us. Now, if we run a simple git merge, we're gonna get what's called a fast forward merge. Git will simply move the head pointer from the tip of the mainline branch all the way up to the tip of your feature branch and essentially absorb that feature branch into mainline without adding any extra commits. This is possible because we used rebase first to re-anchor our feature branch. Well, what if you want to keep your feature branch intact for documentation purposes? Well, you can always add the no fast forward flag and you'll still get a quote unquote merge commit on mainline, but it's going to keep your feature branch around so you can kind of look back on it and see what commits were part of it originally. At this point, you're saying to yourself, well, we're talking a lot about merging here, but what about rebase? Well, you can certainly use rebase to move your feature branch onto mainline. You can check out mainline using git checkout mainline. Then you can run git rebase feature branch, and that will bring all those commits onto mainline and it will look like this. Now, this looks pretty much the same as a fast forward merge, right? Well, not quite. So what's the difference between rebase, a fast forward merge, and then why would you want to use one over the other? Well, those are really great questions that I'm going to cover in depth in my next video, complete with detailed animations, just like this one. So stay tuned and thanks for watching. See you later.